Welcome to St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management. This college is affiliated to Maharshi Dayanand University, Rohtak, and approved by All India Council for Technical Education. This video lecture is a part of series developed for online classes. Hello everyone, my name is Ashish Tripathi and I am working as an assistant professor at St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management since 2015. My areas of interest are data analysis and data visualization, which are recommended to be a data scientist. Welcome to Object Technologies and Programming using Java. In this video lecture of Unit 2, we will study about the this keyword, abstract class, and garbage collection of Java. This keyword. The this keyword is used to refer to the object that invoked it. It can be used inside any method to refer to the current calling object. That is, this is always a reference to the object on which the method was invoked. For example, we are writing the constructor of a class box having the three parameters width, height, and depth. These three are also the variable names of the box class. Hence, to differentiate it, we are using the this keyword before the left side of the assignment operator. Here, the this.width is the member of the class box and the right side width is the parameter value. Here, the formal parameters overlap with the name of the class instance variable. The local variable hides the instance variable because this lets you refer directly to the object. So we can use it to resolve any namespace collisions that might occur between the instance variable and the local variables. So in the figure, you can see that the this keyword is pointing to the instance variable, constructors, and the member methods of the class. Garbage collection. The garbage collection is a technique for automatically deallocating the objects which are out of the scope. It works like this. When no reference to an object exists, then object is assumed to be no longer needed, and the memory occupied by the object can be reclaimed. Garbage collection only occurs sporadically, that is, if at all, during the execution of your program. It will not occur simply because one or more objects exist that are no longer used. The garbage collection is a process of reclaiming the unused memory automatically at runtime. It is a process of looking at the heap memory, identifying which objects are in use and which are not, and then deleting the unused object. A request to run the garbage collection can be made through our program by using the system class as system.gc. The basic functions of the garbage collection are that it finds the data object in a program that cannot be accessed in the future, and the second is that it reclaims the resources used by those objects. The Java Virtual Machine uses an approach known as the mark and sweep to identify objects which can be freed. It also moves the allocated blocks together so that the free memory is contiguous rather than fragmented. Some of the other approaches are as follows. The first is the reference counting. So each time an object is assigned to a variable, the count is incremented. Decrement occurs when the object is set to null or the program goes out of the scope. So, when the reference count becomes zero, then the object is freed. This approach is not appropriate as the object might have a circular reference. The second approach is compacting the collectors. The optimization technique used by the garbage collectors is known as the compaction. It moves the object closer to the beginning of the heap. This process removes holes and adjacent object into a large chunk of free space are being allocated. But it will waste the memory because compacting the object will take some time. The third approach is mark and sweep. It is used by the IBM Java Virtual Machine. In this, the collector looks for the reference of the object in the stack, Java stack and the heap. When it is found, then it is marked. After searching all the object, garbage collector sweep out those the heap, turning all the unmarked object into the free space for the new creation. So it will mark out the object which are being referenced in our program, in anywhere in the program, and all those which are unmarked, those are being collected by the garbage collector. Advantages of the garbage collection. Garbage collection increases their productivity by freeing the programmer's worry of deallocation. So as a programmer, you are always ready to program, that is, you are creating the algorithm or the logic of the program. You should not worry about the memory usage of the program. Garbage collection ensures the program integrity. It eliminates certain kinds of memory leaks like the dangling pointer. But there are some disadvantages of the garbage collection also. Likewise, it degrades the performance in deciding what memory is to be freed and what is to not. The moment of collection of garbage is unpredictable because when the garbage collection will execute, we don't know. Some memory is manually disposed of. Suppose you already delete some of the memory or the object manually, then the garbage collection won't result in an optimized way. Finalize method. This method is used to define specific actions that will occur when an object is just about to be reclaimed by the garbage collector. Before an object is removed by the garbage collector, its finalize method is invoked to give it a last opportunity to clean up its act and free other kinds of resources it may be holding. For example, an object should release some resources such as the file handle before an object is destroyed. The Java runtime calls this method only once, when it is about to recycle an object of that class. Inside the finalize method, you will specify those actions that must be performed before an object is destroyed. The garbage collector runs periodically, checking for objects that are no longer referenced by any running state or indirectly through other reference object. The finalize method has the general form as it is always protected. It doesn't return anything, so it is void. Then you have to keyword finalize. And inside the finalize, you should mention all the closing and releasing of the resources like the file, the network connection, etc. Here the keyword protected is a specifier that prevents access to the finalize by the code defined outside its class. It is not called when an object goes out of scope. This means that you cannot know when or even if the finalize will be executed. It is just called when the garbage collection works. Abstract class. A class in which one or more methods are not implemented or defined, it is known as the abstract class. The class for which one can create object to access the member is called the concrete class. The class for which no object can be created is called the abstract class. Here in Java, abstract is a keyword which must be declared before a class to indicate that it is incomplete and must be inherited by the subclasses to utilize its full functionality. An abstract class may or may not contain abstract method. An abstract method begins with the keyword abstract and does not involve a body. This method must be defined by the subclasses in their own way. So, in Java, whenever you are making a class which doesn't provide the body to any of its methods, then that class will be abstract, and this class will be inherited by the subclasses. Then it is the responsibility of the subclasses to define those methods in their own way. Here are some of the characteristics of the abstract class. Likewise, a class declared with the abstract keyword is an abstract class. This class cannot be instantiated. It should always be extended by the subclasses. It should be used when we want to provide a class with partial implementation. It is used to provide common features to be shared by all the subclasses. It can contain instance variables. This class may or may not have complete method definitions. That is, it can have concrete as well as the abstract methods. If a class does not provide definition to its method, then that class automatically becomes abstract. If a subclass does not define all the abstract methods of its superclass, then the subclass always becomes the abstract class. An abstract class can inherit other abstract classes and to make up the hierarchy. It makes the programming more flexible and easy. An abstract class can implement the interfaces as well. Here is an example to showcase the abstract class. We have an abstract class A in which there is an abstract method named show1. There is also a concrete method show2 having the statement system.out.println where hello all is being displayed. Next, we have a class B which inherits the class A. Now, it is the responsibility of class B to provide definition to the abstract method show1. So, it is providing the definition to abstract method show1. Remember that when you are defining the method, then you don't have to mention the keyword abstract before it. Hence, we are just defining it with the help of void show1. After that, we are seeing that we are providing a statement inside class B. Then in the main function, we are declaring the object of class B as OB. And from that object, we are calling the abstract method show1. So the method is been defined in class B. Hence, the inside class B will be printed. Next, we are calling show2 by this object, then hello all will be printed. Question for today's video lecture are, what is this keyword, what is garbage collection and how it is done in Java, what is the use of finalize method, what is an abstract class in Java. Thanks for watching my video lecture. Hope you have learned about the abstract class and the this keyword. You also have learned about the garbage collection and the finalized method. You keep practicing all these code and wait for my next video lecture. Till then, goodbye and take care.